everyone. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a funny monster in Adobe Illustrator using basic shapes, effects, and gradients. Let's start by making a new document of 600 by 600 pixel size. Take the rectangle tool and click to make a shape of 200 by 250 pixels. Align it to the center of the artboard horizontally and vertically. Let's fill our shape with a nice radial gradient. We'll be using gradients for all the elements of our monster to make them dimensional and vivid. Pick a nice tint of yellow-green for the inner part of the shape and darker green for the outer edge. Edit the position of the gradient with the help of the gradient tool. Now take the direct selection tool, the white arrow, and select the bottom left anchor point. Press Enter to open the Move window and set the horizontal value to minus 20 pixels, moving the point to the left. Do the same for the opposite point, setting the value to 20 pixels and moving it to the right. Select the whole shape and use the Live Corners feature to make the body rounded. Let's add the eyes. Take the Ellipse tool and make a 50 by 50 pixel circle. Change the colors of the gradient to white and light gray, making the eyeball spherical. Copy the shape and paste it in front. Make it much smaller and set the size to 20 by 20 pixels in the Transform panel on top to form the pupil. Change its color to bright red. Add a small white circle for the highlight. Group all the elements of the eye, hold Alt-Shift or Option-Shift and drag to the right, making a second eye. Now make an oval shape with the Ellipse tool for the mouth. Use the Eyedropper tool to pick the red colors from the eye. And use the direct selection tool to drag the bottom anchor point down to make an open smiling mouth. Now let's add the teeth. Make a shape with the ellipse tool. Edit the position of the gradient with the help of the gradient tool. Hold Alt-Shift or Option-Shift and drag to the right. Move the shapes around. Select the teeth and the mouth and take the Shape Builder tool. Hold Alt or Option key and click the pieces outside the mouth to delete them. Now make a green oval for the arm. Go to Effect, Warp, Arc, and set the vertical bend value to 40%, making the arm slightly bent to the left. Object Expand Appearance to apply the effect. Attach the arm to the body, resize it, rotate, and move it around to make it fit the character. Edit the position of the gradient with the help of the Gradient tool. Double-click the Reflect tool and flip the shape of the vertical axis, making a reflected copy for the second arm. Let's copy the arm shape and use it to make the hair. Make the shape much smaller and attach it to the head. Make a few more copies, forming a funny hairdo. Use the eyedropper tool and change the position of the gradient to make the shape blend nicely with the head. Add a tint of yellow to the top of the hair. And place the hair tuft right in the center of the head. Make another copy of the arm and resize it to form the horn. Arrange sand it to back beneath the body. Change the gradient color to yellowish-orange, making the horn dimensional. And add a reflected copy for the second horn at the opposite side of the head. Let's copy the arm again to make the eyebrows. Use the gradient tool to make the brows dark green, fitting the body color. Add a big oval for the tummy and pick the color from the horn. Make the gradient radial and adjust its position and shape. Finally, add an ellipse for the leg. And place it beneath the body. Add a second leg and change the colors to green. Let's finish up with our monster by adding a few minor details. Use the ellipse tool to add a light green spot on top of the head. Copy the spot a few times, making the spots smaller. Move them around, making them fit the head. And add a few more of those to the right arm as well, making our monster look completed. Make some minor adjustments if needed. And that's it! Our funny monster is ready! Great job, guys! I hope you had fun and enjoyed this tutorial, discovering some new tips and tricks that will be helpful for your future illustrations. Stay tuned for more!